Hello students, in this video I discuss some more questions from Alkins which are useful for JE advanced examination and mains exam also. So here in this case the first question is based on the heat of combustion. You know that heat of combustion inversely proportional to stability for isomeric compounds actually. That means a same molecular formula but different isomers. In that case, heat of combustion inversely proportional to stability. In general, heat of combustion directly proportional to molecular weight. With increasing molecular weight, heat of combustion increases. But here, in this case, all have the same molecular formula, okay, and same molecular weight, but different isomers. In this case, you have to identify the stability of the given compounds. So here first A, here in this case we can predict the stability of these compounds based on the chiral conformations, here diaxial repulsions like that. So you know that bulky group occupy equatorial position. Okay, bulky group occupy equatorial position. Why bulky group occupy equatorial position? For suppose if you take this tertiary butyl group in the axial position, and we can take the tertiary butyl group in equatorial position, downward direction. Here in this case, this axial tertiary butyl group very unstable. That means here in this case, this hydrogen, this tertiary butyl group repel with this hydrogens. That's why when the bulky group is in axial position, that is unstable. But when it is in equatorial position, no axial repulsions. Here in this case, it is downward. But here in upper direction there is a hydrogen actually, no 1,3 diaxial repulsions. Of course here hydrogen is a smaller one, okay, hydrogen is a smaller one, no diaxial repulsions. But here when compared with the hydrogen, tertiary butyl group is a bulkier, so high severe 1,3 diaxial repulsions. Here 1,3 diaxial repulsions are severe. That's why bulk group always prefer to stay equatorial position. Okay, so in this case tertiary butyl, first year tertiary butyl I am writing in equatorial position, that's it. Now here these two are in a cis position, so that means here it is upper direction. Now this one also must be upper direction, so methyl. Next year these two are in a trans position, it is upper direction, so now it must be downward direction. Okay, that's it. It is a equatorial, this is the equatorial, this is axial. Now we are coming to this one, this tertiary butyl equatorial. Now here cis one, so it is upward, it is also must be written in a upward direction. Now here these two are also cis, it is upward. Here this one also upward direction. So in this case axial bond, here axial bond. So equatorial, axial, axial. Here in this case, equatorial, axial. Now here, for this one, tertiary butyl again, equatorial position. These two are trans in position, so it's upward direction. Now it is a downward direction. Okay. Next here, this is also trans. It is the upward direction. It is a downward direction. So here, equatorial. All groups are in equatorial. It is a more stable compound. Here in this case, two groups axial, here two groups equatorial. It is a second one. It is the least stable one. So least stable one has a higher heat of combustion. So second compound has a higher heat of combustion. Next here, one more example. Here in this case, decaline type. Okay, this is a decaline type compound. So in this case, here actually this methyl above the plane. Of course, here in this case, this hydrogen I'm taking as above the plane. Okay, so that means these two are in cis position. So methyl. So I'm taking like this here, yeah, So here methyl downward. Here hydrogen also downward. Okay, it is a cis one. Now here these two methyls are cis in position. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, here methyl downward. Here methyl also must be downward direction because here those two are in a cis position. This methyl downward, this methyl also downward cis position. Next here coming to this one. So here like this. This methyl again downward direction. Okay, now here in this case methyl is a cis position. Like it is a downward. This one also downward methyl. Okay, that means here in this case this methyl equatorial, this methyl also equatorial. This methyl axial, this methyl equatorial. Okay, next you are coming to this one, trans. Okay, that means here methyl downward, here this methyl upward. So next here like this. So in this case this methyl equatorial, this methyl also equatorial, both methyls are equatorial. It is the most stable one. Okay, and next this is equatorial, this is equatorial. Okay, so actually here a downward direction, it is upward direction, so it is actually trans. Okay, it is upward direction, it is a okay, it is trans, it is a trans. Okay, here equatorial, equatorial, this one axial, equatorial. Here in this case both methyl groups are not in equatorial position, that's why this is the least stable among the given three compounds. So this one has a higher heat of combustion. Okay, that's it. Next, one more question. In each of the following, predict whether K equilibrium is about equal to or greater than or less than 1. Okay, so here in this case here the, if a that means the product concentration and the reactant concentration are both same, exactly same concentration, then equilibrium constant equals to 1 only. Okay, so in this case trans 1,3 diphenyl cyclohexane. Okay, here in this case trans 1,3, that means here I am writing phenyl upward downward direction. Now here in this case this phenyl in upward direction, because it is trans actually, one phenyl must be downward, one phenyl must be upward direction. So here in this case when the molecule is flipped, that means here there is a conversion, one chiral form to another chiral form conversion. In that case equatorial bond becomes a axial bonds, and axial bonds becomes a equatorial bonds. So that means here these two are equally stable because one is axial, one is equatorial. One is axial, one is equatorial. Okay, and here similar size of the group, that means here same groups phenyl phenyl. So here in this case same concentration K equilibrium equals to 1 only, because these two are equally stable. Next here coming to this one, chiral form of this one. If one isopropyl is in equatorial, it is a cis isomer, it is a cis isomer. If isopropyl is equatorial position, that means your isopropyl taken in equatorial position. Here actually these two are in cis position. Now it is an upward direction, so this propyl also must be upward direction, N propyl. Okay, it is a cis isomer. Now here when flipping this compound, we will get this isomer. Okay, here axial becomes a equatorial N propyl. Okay, now here this equatorial bond becomes a axial. Okay, so here which is a bulkier in nature? So generally this isopropyl is treated as a bulkier group than the N propyl group. So here the isomer which has a isopropyl group is in equatorial position is more stable. That means it is more stable, it is a less stable, because your severe 1,3 diaxial repulsions with a larger isopropyl group. Here in this case also 1,3 diaxial repulsions are working, but your N propyl is somewhat smaller when compared with the isopropyl. Here in this case, isopropyl group, that means N propyl is like this, CH2, here CH2, here CH3. Here in this case, 1,3 diazoxide ribosomes are lesser. But whenever isopropyl group, very severe repulsions, 1,3 diazoxide ribosomes. That's why it is unstable. It is a stable. So K equilibrium less than 1 because product concentration, product side concentration very less. Okay. And next C. Here in this case, methyl equatorial ethyl axial position. In this case, after ring flipping, here methyl becomes axial, ethyl becomes equatorial. Okay. Here in this case, ethyl is in axial position, methyl is in equatorial position. Here in this case, ethyl equatorial position, this methyl axial position. Generally, ethyl is a larger group, so larger group in equatorial position, that conformer is more stable. That means it is a more stable, it is a less stable. So here in this case, K equilibrium greater than 1. Okay, that's it. And next, one more question is, give the common name for A and IUPAC name for B. Here in this case, we have to write the open structure. Here, this is the one carbon, circle is a one carbon. So I am writing the two carbons. Here, this carbon has a two hydrogens and OH group. And rare carbon has a bond with the hydrogen and methyl, this one, methyl. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So of course, it is a common name here, isobutyl alcohol. Isobutyl alcohol. Here in this case, front carbon has a hydrogen and here one more thing, tertiary butyl and secondary butyl. Secondary butyl means a CH, CH2, CH3 and this one CH3. Okay, this is the front carbon, so hydrogen. So next here the carbon, hydrogen, here the bond is phenyl, the bonding with phenyl and bonding with ethyl. That means here CH3, CH2, this one. Okay. So then what is the IUPAC name of this compound? So in this case, if you start from this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 carbons in the parent chain. If you start with this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So 7 carbon chain is the parent chain. Here in this case, 1, 2, 3, it is a third carbon. If you start from this one, 1, 2, 3, third carbon, okay. And it is a fourth carbon, from either side, fourth carbon. On the fourth carbon, there is a tertiary butyl group. On the third carbon, phenyl, from this side, third carbon, methyl. And methyl and phenyl, which one comes first in alphabetical order? Methyl comes first. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That means 5 methyl, here 3 methyl. 4 tertiary butyl. So here the name is 4 tertiary butyl, 3 methyl and 5 phenyl. Okay. 4 tertiary butyl, 3 methyl, 5 phenyl. Heptane. That is the IUPAC name. Okay. For this one we can give the systematic name also. Complete IUPAC name. 1-2-. That means here 1-1-dimethyl, 1-1-dimethyl ethyl. That is the complete IUPAC name. In the place of tertiary butyl group, we can use this one, 1-1-dimethyl ethyl. Okay, that's it. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel and share, like.